وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. I'm now inshallah ta'ala going to go into another contradiction that many of us fall into. And that is الحرص على ضبط المواعيد. We give a lot of importance to the time that we have to meet particular people. If we have to meet a person of يعني position, if we've got a job, we get up early, we make sure we get there early, we sit 5-10 minutes before the time, even an hour maybe sometimes before the time. We make sure that يعني we're early, we're in time for that appointment. If it's documentations, paperworks, legal paperworks that we're doing, we're on time. If we're meeting a very serious person, we make sure that we meet them on time. But when it comes to the prayer, we're the total opposite. This contradiction was something I also encountered with a friend, a close friend of mine. And that was, we slept together one time, we stayed in a place together, and his alarm very often was going off after the prayer time. So I asked him, I said, you have this time only for work? And he has the alarm for the work, for his work. But he doesn't have the alarm for his what? For the salah. So ends up not waking himself with the alarm for the salah, but he does for his work. He never misses it. He makes sure he's on time. He even once, alhamdulillah, may Allah increase it for him, he got chosen in his, from the team that he is, or the team that he's with in his working place. They've elected him as to be the hardest working person. You know, he got rewards for it. His punctuality and his attendance, subhanAllah, praised for it. But when it comes to the salah, there is ihmal. He may pray an hour late, half an hour late, drag his combined between prayers. This is a clear-cut contradiction. When he stands up for work, he irons his thobe, he makes sure he dresses himself up, he gets up, he goes and leaves. When he prays the salah, even when he does wake up, he wakes up lazy. He doesn't want to, no energy, no enthusiasm. قَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says, وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى When they stand up for the prayer, they stand up very lazy. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, He said about the munafiqeen, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ That the munafiqeen are in the lowest level of the hellfire. The munafiqeen, the characteristics that they have, the quality that they have is that the salah is heavy on them. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ When they stand up for the prayer, قَامُوا كُسَالَى They stand up lazy, they can't do it. The righteous people, أَهْلُ الْخَشْيَةِ أَهْلُ التَّقْوَى The salah for them is very heavy, it's important. They see it, heavy is it like it has weight in their minds and hearts. They love it, they're passionate about the prayer. That's why Allah said, وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ The prayer is important. It's very easy, they enjoy it, the people of خَشْيَةِ The people of خُشُوع The people of taqwa. It was authentically transmitted from Tabi'iyul Jalil, Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, that he said, مَا أَذَّنَ الْمُؤَذِّنُ The mu'adhin did not do adhan منذ 30 سنة for 30 years, إِلَّا وَأَنَا فِي الْمَسْجِدِ except that I am in the masjid. We're not talking about iqama. We're not talking about takbiratul ihram. We're talking about adhan. He said, for 30 years I was in the masjid. The imam doesn't say, Allahu Akbar, adhan. I'm in the masjid. I'm in the masjid. 30 years, Sa'id al-Musayyib said. This imam is giving importance to the prayer, the jama'ah, before any and everything. For 30 years for him to do that, Allahu Akbar. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.